So this is a lever that opens this room full of death, basically. Room full of radiation poisoning, which is going to make me sad. I'm not going to go in there.
I really do want someone to remake this, now that I'm watching it so much.
There you go.
I'm not really a nostalgia gamer.
So, whoever wants to remake it, your Kickstarter now has one backer.
But I better see some good premiums.
So I don't know if you guys are hearing the audio logs. I know that I'm pretty sure that the other commentators are not hearing the audio logs. In my talons, I shape clay, crafting life forms as I please. So do we know if they're actually hearing the audio logs, or should I, like, try to give a little plot summary to date? I guess you guys, you commentators, would benefit from a little plot summary to date. You may recall that Nathan Darcy has discovered that Shodan is going to use the laser to do badness upon the Earth. The mining laser to do badness upon the Earth. And he has figured out a plan to thwart this, which involves basically raising up the station's shields, overriding the locks that prevent you from firing the laser while the shields are up, and then firing the laser into the shields, thus destroying that. To do that, we're going to have to get Isotope X-22 from this level, and we're going to have to bring it to the reactor, and then we're going to have to do some other stuff to actually get the shields up and the laser unlocked. Was that helpful?
Absolutely. To me. I didn't remember the plot of our own game.
Dorian, you wrote the Shodan monologues there, is that right? Or
I don't think so.
Well, I didn't. Maybe.
Is it possible that Eric Ray
again, remember, my memory only goes back about 6 months, so it's certainly possible I wrote them, but
I also assumed it was you, Boston.
If it wasn't you, I guess I probably would have been the second person tagged for it. So sure, I'll take credit for it until someone else specifically remembers they did it.
Well, it could be. All right, so this is the cyberspace terminal, which I don't have science access to yet. So I'm going to do a crazy thing. I'm going to make a note on the automap.
Oh, ooh. Wow.
Look at you, hacker.
That's a thing you can do.
Yeah, oops.
And
this is my note. And it's telling me I can double-click to use it, but it's not... Oh, yeah, and I can use it. It says library. But, you know. Yeah, is it possible that Terry did some writing on Shodan?
It is very possible.
We're talking about Terry Brosius, yep. The voice of Shodan, who has done writing on numerous things. She did some writing on Thief, right? And definitely Dishonored, right? She did some writing on Dishonored, didn't she?
She definitely did a bunch of stuff on Dishonored.
Yeah.
Hang on, I gotta log off for half an hour. I shall return.
Alright.
See you guys in a bit.
So, yeah, if you'd like in the audience to claim credit for writing the Shodan stuff,
this is your big chance.
This is your big chance. Oh, there's another cyberspace terminal. You know what? I missed this in my previous playthrough. Alright, let's go check it out.
Whoa!
Shoot the crazy dogs. Shoot the crazy dogs.
Here we go. Cyberspace. Cyber pigs.
Is that all that was? I didn't even see what I got. There's a current in these cyberspace corridors that you can't swim against very easily. Like, if you're super dedicated and really got a lot of coordination, you might be able to do it. Okay, I wonder what I got. Let's see. Let's go look and see. Let's see. Did I get any more games? No, I still just got ping. I didn't get any pulsar. Maybe I got some data. I don't know what I got. Anyone see?
Nope.
So the other thing that you might be amused to know at home is that because of the technical difficulties I was having before earlier, I am playing this entire game in a like 640x480 window in the corner of my, you know, 1900 wide desktop or whatever. Oh, and this is biocontamination, and this is like a cruel practical joke, right? Because you go over here and it's like, oh, it's broken and it's full of poison and you're sad. And it's possible that I'm gonna die, but not before I loot this stuff.
Haha. Right,
let's hit ourselves some. Oh, we don't have any detox. Crap.
And then soon you will. Soon you will detox with death.
Yeah. I really want to grab those. Oh, that's some detox right there. I bet. Oh. And So biological contamination is measured in LBP. What does LBP stand for? I guess there was in Wing Commander, there was like a schematic for the ships that had the damage on them, or the firepower listed on them in EKB, which is supposedly stood for Earth Shattering Kabooms. And I thought that was really kind of corny and stupid, and so I wanted to do something like corny and stupid and also mocking Origin. And so this is like my LBP is like my really stupid, really lame joke. I just want to set it up properly. It stands for Lord British Penises. Because it was just, that was my joke. That was what I could come up with.
It's like we're 14.
Well, weren't we 14 when we made this game?
yeah, pretty much. So yeah, it was just a stupid piece of sophomoric
Than we are now to
humor.
To the age we were then.
Yeah.
Travis Baerga. I think I gave him that name. Reason that I'm fairly well confident that I did give him that name is that when I was put in charge of names for any character in a game, a habit I continue to this day, I mine the rich field of last names of professional baseball players.
There you go.
Which sound a lot like decent, you know, fantasy or science fiction names.
There you go.
I mean, often they are actual, you know, they sound more like names as well. But Baerga was named after Carlos Baerga, who was an infielder for the Cleveland Indians back in the 90s.
So, it's funny, when I want to name stuff, what I do now is I just go look at my spam folder, because, like, the senders of your email are just all randomly named people. So I just pick someone who's, you know, someone I don't recognize who spammed me. So this is interesting. I went a different way through the level this time, and over where? Somewhere in this room, somewhere adjacent to this room, is, I think, there's a murder hole. Yeah, it's right here. See, this is a little window. You can actually get on the other side of this, and you can kill these mutants through the murder hole and never have to deal with them. Although, standard access grant. Okay, so here is where the X-22 isotope is... Oh, I have science access now. I should go back to the library. This is where the X-22 isotope is. It's in this radioactive place. I have to take down... There's another example of our awesome translucent technology. I have to take down that little shield and get it. And maybe I'll just have my detox ready. I think I can preemptively detox, right?
I don't even know.
You don't even know.
There's a good way to find out.
Well, I'll try it. Alright, so... Yeah, it's...
You only have one detox, so it is kind of a risky...
Well, no, see, it's going down to 5, and then it's coming back up to 15, because I keep staying in the room. But... Yeah, it drops right off because of the detox. I think the detox pulses. And, And so, yeah, now I have the X-22 isotope, which I need as a plot MacGuffin for the shield, which is on the reactor level. X-22 is, of course, a reference to Zemu, who was one of the programmers in System Shock, and his fraternity has a certain fascination with the...
Number 22.
Number 22, so that's why that is the way it is. And now I've achievement unlocked 6 grenade types, so... I got a landmine. I think we actually do mark things... We actually do mark things that you have robbed so that the help system doesn't point them out again. Alright, so I have science access now. I don't remember where I got it, but... Oh, and there's this elevator. I can go to the reactor level now, I think. Can I go to the reactor level? Let's see. Look, I'm in the reactor level. And there used to be a huge disk load between those two things. Like, going between, you know, pushing the button. If you were playing in 1994, it would be like, the elevator starts to move. Load. Here you are. But now it's like the elevator starts to move, and it goes right away. Because, you know, hey, we got faster computers. So, I have a story about elevators. Elevators are basically teleporters, right? We have discrete levels of the game, and each one is a separate level file, and the elevator teleports you between the level files, right? And so there's always a level load in between the elevator. So we have this, you know, and so basically there's another copy of this elevator on the reactor level, and we're just teleporting you. We're just unloading your level, loading you, and putting you in the other copy of that elevator. So because elevators were basically teleporters under the hood, we had this bug where if you dropped an item, you know, on the floor of the elevator and then sent the elevator to another floor, you were like, hey, how come that thing on the floor didn't... I mean, if the elevator moved, like, right. How come that thing on the floor didn't come?
It would be with the elevator on one floor and not with it on the other.
Yes. Yeah, so we had this bug. And so we needed to fix this bug, right? And we sort of came up with a system to, like, find all the things in the elevator and marshal them and, you know, and serialize them and bring them along with you to the next level. But the trick was, this, you know, is part of a tile map, right? There's nothing in the level that really marks this up as an elevator, right? Like, this elevator is one tile, so that's easy, but there are multi-tile elevators elsewhere in the level, right? So figuring out which tiles are actually part of the elevator was a problem. Because, you know, it's just geometry. It doesn't know what it is, right? So there was one piece of information that we could use to
determine... I know where this is going. I totally know.
It is whether that tile plays elevator music.
Yes! Right?
So... And I'm on level 2. Do I want to go to reactor level? Sure, let's go to reactor level. Right, did I save? I did save. All right.
The reactor level, if my memory serves, is the one that with the best music. The really driving, pumping music, which I can't hear because I have the game muted, so I don't screw everything up. But
yeah.
So someone will have to, who's hearing it can tell me if I'm remembering right.
I knew that hopper was there. I guess I could have thrown a grenade at him, but... And literally, the only reason I know that hopper was there is because I played this game 2 days ago. Don't be fooled that I'm some kind of a genius.
At least
there's
this
no room
white.
In my inventory for this head. Well, I guess we'll just try and vaporize it and see if it's important. Oh, it's... Oh, that was really loud. I'm so really sorry to anyone who had to hear that. Alright, so what do I want? I want my pistol. Look! Look, it's our friend! Do you think he will like us? No. He is an autobomb. Obviously inspired by the mouse droids from Star Wars, but they are splody. And this is just a security room that's been wrecked. It's got nothing in it. It's just sadness. It's just made of sadness. And over here... Oh, badness. Alright, so now I'm gonna go turn on cyborg conversion.
Anne Raines, I see, is the sender of that one. Named after Tim Raines, longtime outfielder for the Montreal Expos. ought to be in the Hall of Fame.
There you go. Oh, in fact, alright, so this game, we did not get to my voice acting. We actually bypassed it. We'll have to go back to level 2 at some point. But this game includes my voice acting debut. But my... here we go. Oh, we have to do this wiring puzzle, maybe. My other video game voice acting appearance is in a baseball game. I forget, MLB, the whatever Major League Baseball 2K3, maybe. And if some specific player gets a perfect game, I'm the guy in the stands who goes nuts.
I didn't know that. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, no, back when I was a Visual Concept. So here we've unlocked the healing bed and the cyborg conversion, so we're in pretty good shape for this level. I can't really die. It's possible that I'm getting some keyboard repeat issue. Yes, 15 grenades, they are my precious. I will never part with them.
Even if it kills you.
Yes. So here is our BioWare, which tells me what my health and fatigue are as percentages. And this button is the radiation treatment button. So if you're in the reactor level, you can run back here and get
for a
treated. Oh, hello. Are you hearing that loud ding every once in a while? I don't know what to do with that. I was about to use a med patch. That would have been dumb. Oh look, more detox. See, this is the reason why you keep the auto help on. So you can find...
Just point that stuff out for you.
Yeah. Having the auto help on is totally 2D faced, but it's super fun. Oh, hello, Mr. Bomb.
Hey, you went to a lot of work to implement that, Chief, so.
Yeah, no, I mean, it actually does a second render of the screen in, like, paint by numbers version so that it can scan it. It's a low res render, so it can scan it for interesting objects near the center of the screen. So here we go. have cameras pointing at the radiation treatment area. This is security. That's just part of the music. That ding-a-ling-a-ling. It's really... I assume it must be really loud on the feed because it's actually audible to me.
Someone wrote, are there any design choices about System Shock 1 that you regret, aside from the GUI? Do you regret any writing, puzzles, PC designs, levels, aesthetics?
I feel like the wiring puzzles could have been done better.
I think at least in one case, a level that I was working on is less space station-y than it ought to be and more dungeon-y than it ought to be, given that I had just come off of Underworld 2, which was the first game I'd ever worked on, and I don't know, was still kind of junior and dumb and wasn't really thinking properly about how the space was formed. So I suspect if you look at all the auto maps, if there is a map that doesn't look as nicely compact and shaped as the others, it's probably mine. But I had Tim to set me straight eventually.
Huh. I'll take credit. I don't know what I did, but...
So we haven't really seen many wiring puzzles yet. There was just the one that was kind of an intro one that was super easy. So we have two varieties of puzzle. One was like the switch puzzle, and one was the wire puzzle. And the switch puzzle was just sort of like you have to connect all the circuits. I think both of the... Well, I think the switch puzzle was designed by you, Tim, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And you have to disconnect the circuit.
The wiring one was
Doug,
I think.
Toggling one thing toggles another thing, and so you have to sort of work at it until you get it into the right state. And I think those were fine. I think it's the other ones with the wires where it was a mastermind game, and so because there was that like you have this little indicator for how well you're doing, but it's it has local maxima, right? So like you can climb up a local maximum and not get to the perfect solution because you're stuck on a hill, and that wasn't really clear to people, I think.
Yeah.
That's what was going on.
It was obscure.
So I think we could have been clearer about that, definitely. I think we could have cut the fatigue system and had a perfectly good game. There's some tuning choices that I made on things like the wares and stuff that I think we could have done better. So these are blocked by ice, and so I must smash them with my drill in order to get at them. I can't even see where I am. Which was part of the point, was to be disoriented. Yeah, so I think some of the tuning details of the game certainly could have been better thought out. I don't know. What do you think, Tim? Design regrets?
Oh, I'm trying to think of how to articulate. I think there's just like there's a certain degree of overall focus that I wish. So, like, I'm not quite seeing, like, what I would like to.
Right.
The game system kind of grew pretty organically. And this sort of gets back to, there's seven different kinds of grenades, and I don't know what the difference between this and this one are.
Right.
But, like,
there are differences, right? But having, you know, having limited ourselves to like only sort of sharper, I'm always sort of like in favor of like much clearer qualitative differences between different tools.
Right.
And the sheer proliferation of features in here doesn't feel quite, I don't know.
Right. It felt very simmy and a little bit.
Yeah,
RPG,
I'm fond of the freedom of expression that it gives to players, but I don't think it necessarily would have suffered from a little bit of more editorial control.
Right.
I don't know.
So this is a jump. I suck at doing jumps. The trick is to sprint. And the trick to sprinting is to push the correct button. Oh. So those of you may recall that the shock movement keys are... instead of WASD, it's ASDX. So S is forward and X is backward. Which, if you're used to modern games, is completely maddening. Oh, that was a cruel joke. But at least I have the Resurrection Bay in play. I'm gonna save because the worst part is you have the Resurrection Bay and so you forget to save. And then you go to another level where you don't have the Resurrection Bay, and then you lose a lot of progress.
You're shocking betrayal.
Yeah. So, yes, not having autosave. In fact, you know, that would be an opportunity for the mod community. I feel like if we have DOSBox, we probably have some way to, like, just peel off core dumps every once in a while. All right, there's that. Because, hey, energy is the gift that keeps on giving. I think this area has mutants behind it. Yes, 0G mutants. To load. And the door keeps closing on me. You're dead. So did I tell you that the help instructed me to pick up a live landmine at one point?
Oh, really?
Yeah. I was playing with the help on. It was like, double-click to pick up a landmine. Oh, good idea. Kaboom. It was one that I had set, too. So.
That's hilarious.
So this room is a 50% gravity room. Where I'm still getting shot because there's more mutants somewhere. There you are. Click to load.
Right. Is there anything we didn't do in this game?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
There's no bowling simulator in it. I don't think.
I'm trying to think if there's a mini game. You know, and we had to hit all of the... I don't feel like gravity's 50% of standard. I feel like it should be easier to...
You know how long this is? Well, this is going to go forever, so don't... Don't wait for it to be done. Let me know when.
You know, it's funny. Gravity feels 50% of standard. There might be some bug. I'm going to walk out of the room and walk back in. See if I can... Oh, I think I have the shift key stuck down. Because now I'm sprinting all the time. Which is a little bit exciting. Check my BioWare.
yes, you're BioWare.
Fatigued. Yeah, I'm still sprinting all the time. I still have some bug where I feel like my sprint key is stuck down. Well, maybe the sprint key is caps lock. Oh, yeah. Because shift is the sprint key, so smart asses that we were, we made caps lock be the...
Oh, that's
okay. Oh, sprint lock.
Be sprint lock, because you wanted that, right?
Totally.
Am I still sprinting?
Okay.
My fatigue goes up as I jump. I can take some stamina up to get my fatigue back. Of course, I'll pay for it later. Oh, more mutants. Let's try not to die. Oh, look, there's a first aid kit. Right, so our BioWare tells us. And I'm just bristling with battery packs. Maybe I can drop some of these battery packs. Oh, and I have another first aid kit. That would have been handy to remember. Maybe I'll just use one. That was a stun gun, right? No, that is the AM-27 flechette gun. But you know, it is really useful as zero gravity mutants.
That's right.
Alright, so let's go over the various things. We've got the SV-23 dart gun for Sarah Vrilli. We've got the SB-20 mag pulse for Sean Barrett.
Sean Barrett, yeah.
We've got the DH-07 stun gun for I forget who.
Hey.
And we got the spark beam. We've got the ML-41 mini pistol for yours truly. We've got the AM-27 flechette for Artman. I only have one kind of rounds for this. Oh, and I'm sprinting again. Okay, Now I have the shift key stuck down, and I'm hitting caps lock to counteract the fact that I have the shift key stuck down, so... This is just extreme gaming, folks.
That's high tech right there.
Yeah. And I need to wait for my fatigue to come back down so I can make this jump, I think. It's interesting that the shift key does counteract the caps lock. Something weird is going on in the UI. Who wrote the UI? Goddamn.
Huh. Yes. Yes, indeed. Who was that?
Who was that terrible novice programmer? All right, this is here. We're in kind of like the access tunnels of the... Oh, and being shot by no doubt an assassin cyborg. Screw
Place
you, Tim.
Tim.
Where are you?
Oh. Can you hear the cockles of my heart being warmed? Is the mic picking
yes,
that up?
Yes, I surely can.
It is possible that some of these assassin cyborgs I placed, but anyone that I placed, you can still blame Tim.
Right.
Because I only learned my assassin placing skills from him, so.
Right.
I love those guys.
I'm a little bit lost here.
Use the map, Luke.
Yes. Alright, where haven't we been? So it looks like there's a way out behind me. Looks like you might have to loop around.
Oh, yeah.
So one of the things that's challenging and really surprising, I think, is that all of these levels are height maps, right? Like, every single tile has a single floor height and a single ceiling height. And if you wanted to do multi-level stuff, if you want to do anything like a bridge or anything, you had to, like, build it out of other objects, right?
Yeah.
The terrain database. Yep. And there are some levels, particularly the science level that we were just on, the red level.
Oh, there's a huge amount of that stuff going on there.
Yeah, there's a huge... Yeah. It, like, took perverse glee in... And so the auto map, which is all procedurally drawn, really had a hard time with some of this stuff because of all the multi-level... It's trying to draw a 2D map of all this multi-level stuff. Hello, Mr. Bomb. I should really heal up. Oh, look. Thank you, Mr. Help System. You're welcome, says the Help System's programmer.
Huh.
Okay, now this area requires no introduction, because... This is the one exception to the rule of my geographic knowledge did not last 20 years. This is a trap. I think this is your trap, Tim. Is this your trap?
This is, in fact, my trap. I am totally responsible for this trap.
I remember this trap.
I'm not... Oh. And I've been shot at by a cyborg assassin. Okay, well, while my vital signs are being stabilized, I'm going to take a bio.
Oh, dear. Yeah, I remember playing the game a lot, just, like, testing my own stuff and just, like, trying to be really super conscious of my own mental state while doing so. And any time that I felt really safe and comfortable... That was something I really decided I wanted to screw up for the person who came after me.
That's very thoughtful of you.
Yeah, thank you. All right, what else can we... How else can we vamp while...
I'm back. So one important pro tip that I forgot is to always close the force door behind you when you leave the resurrection bay, because if there's enemies outside, you don't want to res.
Right, with it. Have an enemy beating on you every time you take a step out of the chamber, right?
Yes, so. Or the moment you appear. Then at least you have a moment to take your breath and...
That was actually a fairly radical experiment, wasn't it? I mean, the notion of resurrection chambers in the game, where if you set them, then, you couldn't die.
Right.
You just kept playing without losing any progress.
Mm-hmm. Right. I mean, you'd lose geographic progress, obviously. But...
Right, but you wouldn't lose in, inventory progress.
Yeah. I really like the effect that it had of, like, the tension of, like, trying to get to the Resurrection Chamber on each new level.
Yeah, right. It gave you an automatic sub-goal that was very important.
Yeah.
Kind of just minimize the kind of immersion breaking routine of, oh, you died, here's a cutscene, here's a load screen,
yeah,
here go do some stuff again. It made the game feel much more fluid. And I think it was well worth the puzzle.
It's hopefully going to help me with this death trap. So the wiring puzzles are basically mastermind. And so you can get partial credit for right wire wrong color. Right, and so I swapped the colors of the wires, and then... Oh, and that turns on a light, so that when the lights... when the death trap springs, I'm not totally blind. It's possible that I should go back to the science level also, because there's a shield wear that I didn't pick up. That might help me with combat on this level. Oh, being shot at by Tim's friend.
I prefer to think of them as minions.
Tim's avatar. Who needs batteries? Should have been talking to its cyborgs. Climbable surface. The ladder climbing UI is not super clean, but that's another thing we could have done better. And I keep the geometry of the thing keeps pushing me off the...
Oh yeah, the overhang.
Crouch.
Arr.
But apparently the middle state of crouch is sufficient for that. Look. I bet whatever's behind there is going to be really poisonous and dangerous. And I do have some detox, so, you know, what the heck. Teflon rounds loaded. Let's go. Being shot. Cyborg.
If only you'd recently saved your game.
Oh, yeah. Alright. So, Tim and I played in a... all three of us played in a role-playing game that Zima ran. A Champions game.
Yep.
Where Laura Baldwin also played in that. She was the author of the Bear Pitts monologue, or dialogue, rather, in Thief.
She did a lot of writing in Thief.
She did a lot of things, but, you know, that's kind of...
That's her famous work.
The fan favorite.
The most famous work. And so in this role-playing game, she had the special power of... she had precognitions with the special effect of she could save her game. So she would say, I save my game, and then I see what's through the door. And that would
yep. Yep.
I'm sure you guys all wanted to hear about our role-playing characters.
Let's see if our number of watching now.
Yeah, I mean, it's probably just the three of us at this point, but, you know.
All right, let me tell you about my character.
Yeah.
I played Disappearing Man.
Yeah, let me tell you about my paladin. Okay.
dear God.
So how am I going to deal with this jerk? It'd be nice to have more health, that's for sure. Maybe I'll just throw some more patches on. And I don't really want to use it. So I don't remember. Is Hornet good against cyborgs? Anyone remember?
I don't remember.
Anyone in chat remember? Like, I don't know. Like, I guess that's another regret. It's like, I don't know that there's good help on... You know, I don't know how
chat's,
you would find
chat
out.
Chat says yes. Oh, no, wait. I don't know if they're talking about...
No, but we're talking about...
No, that's a different question. Never mind.
We're talking about how the sprites were created.
They do want to hear about our role-playing characters.
No, not that. Oh, look. We just lost a couple more watchers.
There you go.
We still have 183 people, apparently, watching this channel.
I have no explanation for that, but there it is.
All right, maybe I should try something else elsewhere. Maybe I should... Oh, right, because I think there's just... there's some good stuff on that corpse,
I see
but...
shurikens coming out of the dark. Well, that was 30 seconds ago that I saw it, but it was still heartwarming.
Yeah. Oh, and I have security access now. So I get to load up on goodies. Yes, another pro trip. Double-clicking on the container while the container is open just gets you the next thing out of it, so you don't have to constantly... There's a note. Hey, a targeting ware.
I'm trying to... Someone's asking about the design of the laser rapier, and I'm trying to remember who that was.
Well, again, we must have all the tropes, right? So we've got our phaser, the spark beam. We've got our lightsaber, the transparently named laser rapier.
Yeah.
We've got... Like... If it has ever occurred... in space, in any fictionalized form, it is in this game. Alright, let's look at our map. See where we haven't been yet. I guess we can just keep wending our way around. It's possible that we're gonna have to kind of give up on the reactor level and... possible that we're going to have to give up on the reactor level and head over to storage or whatever level 3 is and get a rad suit. Oh, that might happen eventually. Or we can spring the trap. We can always spring the trap. Because that'll go well for us.
Why wouldn't you spring the trap?
Well, it's just whether I'm ready to spring the trap, and I don't actually need the shield override yet because I haven't done all the other stuff. But, yeah.
Yeah.
And I also don't have the shield wear. Maybe I should actually go back to their science level and get the shield wear. Right, that was the home of a lovely bomb. And here's the trap.
Hey guys, it's Austin. I have returned.
Hooray!
Welcome.
Huzzah.
Where have we gotten to?
We've gotten to the trap. We're in the reactor level. Haven't made a ton of plot progress yet. I've got the isotope X-22, and I'm looking for the shield thing to drop it off into. I suspect that eventually I'm going to have to head back up to level 3, which I think is storage? To get a rad suit, or maybe it's engineering. And then... I'm gonna put a landmine And this is the moment where, in fact, this is the piece of the help system's advice that you should not follow. If you try to double pick a live land, a double click on a live landmine, it will explode your face. Maybe I can just flechette. And I don't want to be exposed to that door because I'm pretty sure that's got a security bot behind it. Again, not a naive playthrough. If you were expecting a blind shock playthrough, it's more like a 20 years nearsighted shock playthrough. So.
No, but it shows off some of the thinking and planning you can do around the game systems.
Right, so maybe I will try and sprint and then whip around and see if I can... Well, I don't want to hit my own landmine, that's the problem. All right, here I go. Leroy!
Nice.
Bye, Mark. Nice knowing you.
Yeah.
We'll all meet again as Cortex Reavers.
Thankfully, I have the res bay open, so you will not meet me as a Cortex Reaver quite yet.
Oh, wow.
Welcome to my death machine.
Yeah, that was brief.
That was an extremely efficient death machine.
A heroic effort.
Yep.
How long do speedruns go? Like, how fast can people speedrun Shock? That is a question I have.
Well, alright, so when the game launched, we had a launch party where we did a playthrough, and we did it in about 5 hours. We're, like, coming up on that already, I feel like.
We're at about three.
Have we discussed the VR support for Shock 1?
I mentioned it on the System Shock forums, but yeah, we did actually have this working on the headsets of the day, which was the Forte headset, I think, was the main one, and what was the other one? The eyeglasses, I forget what the company name was called. i-glasses. That was before i-things were owned by Apple. Or i-things were owned by Apple. Hello, Cyborg Assassin. Hello. Say hello to my little flechette friend. Sadly, I'm going to run out of that stuff pretty quick if I keep persisting with it.
According to chat, current speedrun record is hour 24.
Wow. Nearly blew myself up with a grenade.
I don't know what the difficulty settings are, but wow.
Well, all right, yeah, of course, if you are playing on plot zero, then all the doors are open, so you can just walk right to the end boss.
Right.
I don't know if that counts, though.
Yeah, probably not what we're talking about.
Are you, like, almost dead?
Yes.
Yes, I was almost dead.
Anyway, I remember the VR hardware on Shock and how awesome it was, I have to say.
It was pretty cool. I think that compared to what you can do with an Oculus now,
yeah.
One of the things is, you know, we got sprites, right? So, it does come across as slightly view mastery, right? To see sprites just sort of floating in 3D.
Although I have to say, at some point that will return as an aesthetic, like kind of as a deliberate thing. Like.
Oh yeah, totally.
Oh yeah, like 8-bit.
Right. Totally.
Yes. 8-bit. Who needs visual language?
Yeah, that would be another thing for the Shock review. It would have to be VR.
So I guess another design regret that I have is I feel like we kind of copped out on the security cameras. You know, they're just things that you kind of clean out to get the number down. And I think Shock 2 and games since have done a much better job of, you know, the camera can see you and you can react to it and
right. It
actually feels like a camera as opposed to just a MacGuffin.
Like, the cameras in System Shock are basically just feeding into sort of an overall security
number.
Level that you're trying to wear away.
Hey,
at.
Mr. Security Bot, did I already kill you? You know, I didn't. Don't die. Alright. Top up.
I guess my point about 1994 VR, which was that it was kind of... Oh, I'll let you I'll let you sort this guy out. Nice. It was kind of a joke, but not. Even in 94, you could see that it was, like, the forerunner of something really compelling.
Yeah, it was clearly gonna happen.
Yeah.
You know? I really liked the, we had a Flight Unlimited, one.
Oh, yeah, that was fantastic, yeah.
Pretty interesting.
You would look over and see down the wing to the ground.
It was actually really cool, and it was cool because you could fly around in a canopy-less plane.
Yeah.
This is the very mutant that, like, killed me over and over again, like, when I walked through that door down there.
Hello.
And now these bars are actually totally impenetrable. I can't actually shoot through them, so I can try, but... But yeah, this is actually opaque to gunfire. It's actually a window. So it is just he is just standing there taunting me.
Awesome. Yes, he is.
And this is the reactor. And I don't think I really have the health or the... I can try the flechette. I got some more ammo for it. I don't really think I have the real wherewithal to actually go in here, but I'm gonna give it a save game. And a college try.
Yeah, let's have some can-do attitude here.
Yeah. okay, so am I gonna burn my last first aid kit on this? Maybe.
Here it is. The eyeglasses were from Virtual IO.
There you go.
Alright, Barefoot Monkey on chat says, save.
Thank you, Barefoot Monkey. You rock. Alright. Which way to turn? Okay, I think there's an exec bot over here.
Hi.
And I used a whole flechette clip on it. Great. But it gave me a flechette lock clip, so that's something. Oh, and this isn't actually radiation-y yet.
Awesome.
And we have a switch, and we have a... Hey, we have the roller skates.
Sweet.
Now that's the repulsor control, so I can go down.
Oh, that feels more like 1979 period.
Yeah.
Roller skate chic.
So I don't know the combination to put in here. I could, like, dig through my logs. I don't know if I'm supposed to know it yet, though. Let's dig through our logs.
So I'm going to have to take my own break for a while.
All right.
I heard my family's just arriving home, and I've left my wife has been in charge of the kids all day, and we'll need some help when they all come in. So...
All right, have a life.
I'll go have a life briefly, but then I'll come back if you're still here.
Okay.
Do you have any sense, Mark, about how long you're going to keep this up?
Well, it's only 4 o'clock here in the Pacific time zone, so I'll probably keep this up another few hours.
Right,
if I lose my voice, then maybe I'll be silenter, but...
Right. Well, I'll be back to join you soon. Good luck.
Yeah,
cool.
Yeah.
Talk to you.
I've hunkered down. I've got my Bloodshot pizza box, my caffeine overdrive sorrow. I'm ready for... I don't know that I will actually finish the game... Alright, so he's asking what's up about the Envirosuits. Sabo in the storage level will have one if anyone does, but he might not have biosuits. I only have biosuits. I'm still clicking on the same log. Okay, so there's no level 2 logs that are going to tell me about the...
Yeah, note that this game actually does make you learn the combination and input it.
Right. And,
how
you know,
else would you do it?
This was, you know, again, this was a small team relative to modern teams, and it was a short project relative to modern projects. And, so I think that Mark Steinberg is voiced by Tim Stelmach.
Yes.
I don't know if you can hear that, but, I think it is so.
Shard, this is Mark. can't make it to the thing we were going to do because the reactor is blah blah blah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we'll get to mine back on the science level eventually. Mine is, this is crazy. I've been locked out of my own office.
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah. I did not quit my day job after doing that audio log. Oh, interesting. So this is a repulsor lift that's kind of keeping me from going down into this little crawl space. And so I don't know if this... Yeah, there's probably some other switch somewhere that...
Right, repulsor lifts were another feature we had.
Here, that's a repulsor lift. I rode one over there. And
one of the things is,
we have repulsor lifts and we have ordinary geometry lifts, right? And the ordinary geometry lifts were like, we just literally, this is the radiation area. Ooh, this is the reactor. I should have known that from it being all reactor looking. I'm going to detox and think about this. There's a zero G mutant.
Do you want me to tell you the combination code?
Can you tell me where to find it? That's the better information. Because
no.
I want to know if I'm like totally circumventing the plot by... Like if it's found on some level I don't even have access to yet, then that seems like dirty pool. Is that dirty pool? Why don't we take a vote on the chat? Is that dirty pool?
I'm not going to vote.
What?
I'm not going to vote. Oh, wait, here are the logs in German. That'll help.
There you go. So I feel like in any case, I need to get a radiation suit before I really get further along with the plot.
The text chat is taking you to task here.
For what?
Just look in your data folder, damn it.
Oh, is it in there? Oh, data.
Oh, under data rather than logs. Okay.
Hospital armory code.
So data object on level 2. Okay.
Data object on level 2? Okay.
Okay.
Cyber 2. Cyber 1. Hospital armory code. That's the...
Yeah, which code are we looking for?
We're looking for, like, the shield override control code.
Okay.
So this is actually... There's a sign here that says safety override access. Yeah, we're looking for the safety override code. So it's possible that I didn't pack that up. I think this is a good time to sweep back through science and finish the cyberspace on the library, which we may be in. And
that's what they're saying now, in fact. It says here at the library cyberjack.
Yeah, I didn't actually use the library cyberjack because I'm dumb. No, because I didn't have access at the time. And where am I going?
Okay, the chat is mercilessly spamming you with the code.
Oh yeah, alright. Okay, so it sounds like... It sounds like the consensus is that we should go and just do this.
Well,
all right.
My only point here is that there is a lot more of the game.
There is a lot more of the game, sure. We don't have to...
We delivered some geometry for your money.
We don't have to actually do every single thing. So yeah, all right. So we have repulsor lifts and we have regular lifts. And repulsor lifts are these things that we had to actually write special physics code to support. Regular lifts are just like we mutated the geometry. As the lift goes up and down, and
right.
And I guess that's code too. But all right, hit me with it. What's the number?
It's 199.
You know, I feel like I knew that once.
It, almost certainly you did. But honestly, it's fine that your brain space was given up to other things.
There you go. So one of the consequences of the difference between repulsor lifts and regular lifts, nobody cares that I'm saying this, but I'm going to say it anyway. One of the consequences is that There's not a really lot of fidelity in terrain height, so we're kind of like the regular guy lifts are kind of teleporting from height to height to height to height. You know, it's like the lift is literally like going up a foot at a time. Whereas the repulsor lift is this special physics hack that like kind of puts a floor under you and pushes you very smoothly. I feel like that just as a technical point, this isn't really a design point. I feel like the physical lifts are very clunky feeling. That like to have if you know a lift that goes up a foot at a time, teleporting each time, would make you vomit.
I have several questions here. One is, okay, but like, why did we put a separate, when we already had physical lifts, why did we put repulsor lifts? Just because
lifts actually are good design space. Because you saw that we have that puzzle where it's like, oh, the repulsor lift is pushing me up, so I can't,
right.
You know, it's actually a blocker in a way that It lets you use the space in a different way, I guess. It gives you more efficiency there. I guess the real question is, why did we do the regular lifts? That would be my question.
Yeah, I feel like we just thought it would be awkward if that was the only elevator technology, right? But that's
right.
A little weird. I don't know.
We already had regular elevators from Underworld, right? Didn't?
Yeah, I mean, basically, we had changing floor heights in Underworld and.
Although this is an entirely new engine, right? Like there's no shared code between Underworld and System Shock because System Shock was our first game on a true 32-bit memory model.
Yes.
Which may not mean anything to the non-programmers there, but back in the day, there was this thing called the IBM PC, and it only could access a meg of memory. And so to do more than a meg of memory, when machines started to get more than a meg of memory, you had to do all these shenanigans to only look at a meg of memory at a time and swap them out and stuff. And I'm seeing hit reticles now because I have the level 1 targeting wire. And I forgot to come here and do this, do these CPU cores, so... Grenade! Uh-oh!
Oh.
So I see another really good question in the chat, which was like, why was the reactor level designed so that most of it could be skipped? That reminds me of the discussion about the speed run. Because I mean, in that sense, like Ultima Underworld was designed so that most of it could be skipped. Like the fastest speed run of that, even before we shipped, was like 45 minutes. Like beginning to end, you could play the whole game. And I think that record has since been broken. In that sense, like there's very little in the sense of hard blockers in these games. That was kind of okay in that, like, you know, we talked about that a lot, and honestly, like, it's not, like, it's more about, like, what are the scenarios you actually expect players to do in, like, an actual playthrough? Like, yeah, I can get a guide that will show me how to go through this level really, really quickly.
Oh.
But if I choose to do that, you know, that's, you know, you paid your... You already paid your nickel for the game, and you can play it any way you want, as far as we were concerned.
Right.
And in the process of exploring the game, you were extremely unlikely to just sort of, like, chance across the speed run.
Oh, only one? Oh. And where am I? Am I all the way back here? Did I forget to save? Yes, the exec bot's still alive. Oh, man. Sorry, folks. But now I know the code, so I'll just power through this. Note to self, save. Okay, what's a good... Maybe I'll sacrifice a magpulse on this guy. Sean has a story about how in the readme of System Shock, there's a thing at the very, very end that says, oh, by the way, save up your Magpulse ammo. You know, and we meant, like, for the security level, you know, because where, like, the Magpulse is, like, it's all security robots, and the Magpulse is a really good thing to have, right? And, he just saved up his Magpulse ammo, like, till the end of the game, because he assumed there was, like, some giant boss at the end of the game that you're going to use all your Magpulse ammo on. So he, like, never used any Magpulse ammo, ever.
That's wonderful.
And, you know, that's a thing that, you know, kind of has plagued games like this since forever, which is just the hoarding problem of how do you signal to people how long to save something? You know, how do you know when it's
the rainy day?
Yeah, how do you know when it's the rainy day? Yeah, exactly. And we tried to solve that in Thief by just not having stuff carry over from one level to another. It's like every level's the rainy day. But it's a tricky thing. In Shock 2, I feel like in Deus Ex, I had this problem where I saved all my stuff. Or you accumulate ammo throughout the game, right? And so you learn to play with one set of weapons, and then by the end of the game, you just sort of throw your hands up and say. You just throw your hands up and switch weapons because you've stockpiled all this. You've inadvertently stockpiled all this ammo for these other weapons, and it's like it behooves you to give up on your current playstyle and pick up a new playstyle at the end of the game just because you've got all this ammo stockpiled.
Yeah.
And they tried to solve that in Deus Ex 2 with unified ammo, and that was not popular. All right, I'm going to save.
Yeah, especially in a game like this where like scarcity is so much a part of the aesthetic of the thing. On the other hand, like that, knowing that I have the responsibility for those decisions is also a big part of the aesthetic of the thing, right? Like it is the game on some level like trusts me more than a game that is not as resource bound.
Right. I think there may be some hack where you can pull out the save game from your last elevator trip, but. I don't know, maybe someone on the internet knows how to do that.
Okay, well, there's a text note that says the elevator begins to move, so it's like a text adventure.
Yeah.
Like, that is
no,
so
yeah,
odd.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
That is
there's,
so odd.
There are, you know, yeah, we had moments like that where it's like...
There's a narrator.
We just...
Yeah, it's like, who's saying that?
send you a message... That's yeah. Like we no, like the dungeon master is telling you, okay, you got in the elevator and it starts to move, and you can imagine the dungeon master doing his little elevator.
Well, and there were bits in the Underworld games where like maybe you'd flip a lever and there'd be text in your interface scroll that would say like you hear the sound of distant rumbling.
Right.
No, I don't. Like this is an audio video game. There are sound effects, and that wasn't one of them.
Right.
Hello, guys.
Hey, Dorian.
I'll be back briefly
for
some amount of time.
All right.
My wife takes care of things. Then I'll have to go again for a while. Then I'll come back for a while.
All right.
Awesome.
That's my schedule.
Well, you know, I don't know how much of this I will end up doing, but whatever I do end up doing... Oh, security bot. Whatever I do end up doing will be fun. Yeah, unlikely to make it to the... final boss, but
given that the final boss am I remembering correctly that the final boss is in cyberspace, or am I conflating
final boss is in cyberspace again? Yes.
Okay, all right.
Yeah.
And is hilariously enough frame rate dependent. It is harder if you have more CPU.
Wow, how did we let that one by?
We let a lot of things by that we shouldn't have, let's put it that way.
I remember we had a bug in Underworld, which thankfully I think we caught before we shipped, but if your frame rate was high enough, when you tried to open a door, the change in the door's angle in a given frame would round down to zero.
Oh.
The door just wouldn't move if your frame rate was too high.
Right. So there was a bug in this game. I don't know if you can still do it, but so Seamus did the physics system, and the physics of the character, you're kind of like this snowman. You're made of two spheres, and it's possible to get a door in between your two spheres. So like your head is in one side of one room, and your body is in the other room. Your upper sphere is in one room, and your body is, it's like you'd be stuck until you couldn't move until you opened the door again. And
I believe the technical term was your thorax and your abdomen.
Ah, thank you. Okay, how many times am I going to do this part before I clue in?
Yeah, I'm trying to remember other frame rate dependent bugs, but I know we have them.
Well, I'm sure the head bobbing in Ultima Underworld.
Oh, right.
Was frame rate dependent. So if you play the game on too fast a machine, you basically, it's a recipe for motion sickness. Oh, they really did not appreciate that. Get the logic probe.
Are those computer nodes built to look like the MCP in Tron? Is that meant to be?
Yeah, maybe. Oh, I'm being shot at.
Oh, kill it.
Good use of a grenade there, though.
Not clear it's a good use of a grenade. I mean, it's not like they were moving. I could have used a lead pipe on them, but...
Let me rephrase. Hey, you used a grenade to some good effect. Nice job.
I occasionally use grenades.
Well, you know, I think overthinking is one of the themes of System Shock.
As our followers are witnessing. All pain, no gain. All right, so maybe concussion... All right, let's do some experience. Maybe concussion goes around walls? Oh, I should have saved. Oh, well. Nope. And that put me to almost death. Okay. Let's go get another mini patch or two. All right, nitro goes around walls. Let's try that. So crazy, it just might suck. Yes, nitro packs go around walls. They're on a timer. And look, I made my life easier with grenades. Better living through grenades. Better living through not dying. Dummy crouch to fit in this.
Whatever you do, don't save your game.
Alright, so here we have... Something's going on in here. What's going on in here? This is, some Hopper love and some maintenance bot love. Oh, and I think this is where you turn off robots. I think there's, like, you can turn off robot conversion here, or robot production here, if I recall correctly. I'm bristling with batteries. I should really... look at all those batteries. I should really do more spark beam. 3 access granted. I don't know if I need that. Access panel is locked. Access panel is locked.
Kells, wow, it's keeping track of... Wait, Kells 172, it says.
Yep.
It's nice that it's keeping track of that. I forgot about that.
Let's see if I can do this here. Swap them? No. Swap them back? Interesting. Swapping and swapping back has almost no effect. Okay. There we go. Perfect resolution. It's still locked. Oh, I need the keypad. Does someone want to give me the code?
Which one is it?
I think it is... It's in the, I'll read, there's a sign here somewhere, hold on. Robot maintenance room. Science level robot maintenance room. I might have it, and I can check my data. Reader?
I bet the chat crowd is much more up on these things than I am.
Yeah. No, I'm just waiting for someone to tell me what it is in chat, because I can't read the chat. Sorry, guys. My chat computer is borked. Oh, no, it unborked. 251. Thank you.
Really? Where was that? That was not very inventive of us.
Access denied. No.
Oh, okay.
On a paper in the room. Oh, it's on a paper in the room. Right. No, it is. It's right here. 623. Thank you. Yeah, so if you were watching and you were expecting us to, like, reveal awesome secrets about the geometry or the plot or something...
Well, there's a lot of discussion about how the physics system works with the terrain and how that's... Mm-hmm.
How collision works, it looks like.
Yeah, collision is...
I mean, does it use the polygons we're seeing, or does it generate some crap?
It uses the polys you're seeing, yeah, absolutely. But you're like these spheres, and it's really low fidelity. And another thing to remember is that at the time, we could not rely upon floating point math. So, because...
That was way too high-tech.
That was way too high-tech. You could get this thing called a 486SX, which is a CPU, and the SX stood for sucks, because basically these were things that they had where the floating point was totally broken, but they sold them anyway. And so everything in the game, all of the math in the game, is fixed point. So we were really struggling against our technical limitations when we... made this game. I mean, I'm sure we would have wanted to make the physics system better, but we could not. Where's the way out? There's another way in this room, isn't there? Oh, I think it's this one. I guess I could look at my map.
Ah.
Oh, right, this is the way out. Okay. So I think I want to kind of angle around this way. I don't think I've... Let's look at the map and see where I haven't gone. Yeah, I haven't gone to this side of the science level, so... Oh, but we should go to the library, huh? Shall we take a trip to the library? That's in the other direction. Alright, let's take a trip to the library and then we'll... Oh, let's put on our roller skates and skate on over to the library. Really fast.
Yee-haw!
Does anyone feel like recapping for me what the icons down each side of the screen are?
Yeah, like, sure. I'll mouse over them for you. The top left one is the BioWare, which gives you information about your health. And also, I think, is the... when you're not in full screen, it gives you the crazy ticker thing, which shows you actual stuff about you, your energy usage, your fatigue, and your... I think that's like your mental activity, which has Sakai waves, which has something to do with cyberspace. Or Sense Around, which is your rearview mirror.
Right.
Over here, we get the mapper, which also can be turned on for a handy-dandy compass, if you're into that. I suppose I should be using that more. The data reader, which is just how you read your email. And then the roller skates.
All right. It comes back to me now. Yeah. I kind of liked having him there.
Oh, hello, Mr. Robot. Eat my spark beam. Oh, Mr. Other Robot, though, has something to say about me. Oh, when did I save?
Right back around when Tim told you not to.
Yes. Right, so we can quick run through here, do this, and then we'll run back. And I'm still squatting. Oh, I thought you were dead. You were so not dead. Oh, you're still not dead. Oh, I'm not doing any damage to it, because I don't have my Teflon loaded. Alright, try again. Stand up. Shoot you, please. Shoot. Don't save your game at low health. Alright, so first thing we do is...
Are you out of med packs?
No, I'm just out of brains.
See. Well, that
that's the problem. There's your trouble right there.
So whoever it was that whoever it was on the forums who said that you were going to take a drink every time I make a mistake, I hope you are well and truly hammered by now.
They're dead.
Yeah, possibly. Passed out. All right, I'm going to save.
What?
And then I'm going to get my Teflon on. And you know what? I'm going to save right over that. Because that's just another thing that I might forget to do if I reload. Come at me, bro. Brobot. Corpse has a soda can. Someone I remember back in the day saying that they used to use soda cans for grenade practice. That they would like just toss soda cans to try and bounce them off walls and get a feel for the physics. Just kind of amusing.
Clever thing to do.
Yeah.
623. Oh, I didn't even do the I didn't even do the access panel after I did that. I like unlocked that and then didn't actually cancel the robot production because I'm so smart. I'm gonna save again. So yeah, one of the things you may or may not know about the UI or the throwing UI is that you can actually impart lateral velocity by dragging. Like if you drag that way, you throw way off to the side. Where's that soda can? If you drag up, you, well, that's a bad example, because I just smacked the ceiling. But if you drag up, you like can add extra height. And if you drag down, you can lower your height, all that stuff. Why was that important? Not really, it wasn't really. But it's a sort of better alternative to, you know, some kind of swing meter or something. It did give you a little bit more control over your throwing without being totally dorky about it. Look, a meta patch. I sure could use that. Right, and this is the room of the X-22 that I don't actually need to visit. And now we're gonna say, why not? And throw on our roller skates and head over to the library. Can we pass it? I think we passed it. Yes. My trail of security bot breadcrumbs will lead me to the library. Not to mention, hopefully this. Alright, so last time we were here, we got our butts killed. And this time, I'm gonna try not to do that as much.
Maybe just half your butt.
Well, I wasn't at full health when I opened the door, so.
Well, you're not at full health now either, so.
There you go.
Lean like the wind.
Lean with the wind. Guy in here? No. Alright, so we got the bunch of toys. We got the. Alright, we got the email reader. Great, thanks. We got the mapper again. And we got the targeting wire again. We already had all that. And here's another example of health help system giving you bad advice. I'll try this guy. So this is a wiring puzzle. Ooh, that was better. Alright, I'm gonna swap colors with that guy. That seemed a little better. That seemed not different at all. Whose idea was it to do this sort of vibrate-y thing where, the meter on the wiring puzzle kinda. Oh, that was worse.
You mean vibrates not in relation to any kind of analog input you are giving it?
Yeah.
Where it's just oscillating around its where it actually is.
Right.
I don't know who that was.
Alright, let's swap colors here and see if that matters. No, that's worse. It does matter. Okay, maybe. Screw it.
Wow. The puzzle is too hard.
There you go, that was the solution. Oh, look! Hey, the laser security override code is 199! There you go.
Hell surprise.
Oh, I'm using my drill on these guys. That's not gonna work. That's much better.
What is that?
Isn't it obvious?
Yeah. Is this a voxel-based situation?
Those are voxel guys, yeah.
Sweet.
Guys are voxel-y.
Yeah, I forget why you even had them.
Because we wanted cool cyberspace guys.
They looked like cyberspace. Exactly, it looked like cyberspace.
Because we must have everything in Sister John.
Like I said, I'm playing without the mouselikeware I mentioned earlier. Just for authenticity's sake, not because I necessarily enjoy it.
No.
The mouselikeware is awesome, and if you were going to play this game...
As the on-screen text just told us, personal integrity restored.
Yeah, so I...
Using mouselikeware would degrade your personal integrity.
It's like medieval times.
I have one...
I have my
cyber health bar as my personal integrity, and I pick up little health nuggets to.
Ooh, look at that dude! Now,
Optimus Prime is shooting at you.
I think he shot his buddy too. I think that the little doggy there that was at the front was.
Yeah, well, cyber entity on cyber entity violence is the worst.
it's a cyber entity eat cyber entity. World.
So those of you wondering whether the lit panels on the sides of cyberspace are in fact Conway's Game of Life, the answer is, I believe, yes.
You are totally kidding me.
Wow.
How did you not open with that?
I don't know. There was some other topic at the time.
That's all I'm looking at now.
Yeah, can you hold still for a second so we can verify that?
the two by two blocks are stable, and as soon as something hits the 2x2 block, it...
You are totally right.
Oh, yeah, and I can light them up, too.
If you shoot it, does it...
In a sense,
oh, yeah, look,
it,
it's a...
Does it flip them?
Yeah. Yeah, like, totally.
You're totally right. In a sense, you are very wrong. yes, you are totally... That is... Oh, god damn it. I'm sorry, that is the coolest thing I learned today. I
had known that at one time, but my brain...
Yeah.
Alright, I have to leave again, this time probably for about 45 minutes to an hour. So
alright.
If you're still here, right. 5 minutes to an hour, I'll come back again.
Have fun.
Alright.
See you.
Good luck.
I'll be here.
Take care of your memos.
Yes.
Alright, follow the arrow.
Where is that? Oh, is this like a secret door or something?
Oh, I don't know. The guy who made this level just left.
How do we? Oh, I see. No, this is the door.
Is there not music in cyberspace? I'm not hearing anything.
I think
there
is cyberspace music. Is there?
Hmm.
Yeah, someone couldn't hear what was it's Conway's Game of Life is the flashing of the tiles. Oh, I'm getting shot at by something, by several somethings. I may not have the cyber... I may not have what it cyber takes for this cyber fight.
There's a lot of dudes.
Just spamming. Okay, so let's see. Is there any health around? Yes. Cyber health.
Right. Like we have in the future.
Ooh, I got a security card. Nice.
Obsolete.
All Group 4 access.
All right.
And out we go. And save.
Nice.
Oh, I almost tried to play the game with the mouse there. That was a mistake. Okay, so I've gotten that. I think I'd like to swing around the other side of the science level and get the shield and some other stuff. I think I have access to here. Okay, this will be comical. Oops, I hit the energy drain mine, which drained my energy. I believe the shield is down, so I believe that, in fact, if I push this button here, I will lose the game. Who wants me to push the button and lose the game?
Yay!
So, anyone? I might have to restart the game if I do that, so I'm not going to, because I think it'll... boot me back to DOS, and I don't really want to boot back to DOS.
Oh, no, we don't want that.
Oh, and I just lost the chat again. Because my other machine that I'm putting on the chat is... Next time I take a bio break, I'll get my other... I'll get a laptop.
The laser! Sorry.
You want me to shoot the laser?
Well, maybe you should save your game, and then,
I did save the game.
Yeah. Then what on earth is stopping you?
Alright, shoot the laser! Here we go! On! Thank you, human. You have saved me some trouble, and you suck.
Alright, so while we're restarting everything from the beginning of everything.
No, yeah, alright.
Oh, come on.
I thought it booted you back to DOS, but it doesn't actually boot you back to DOS.
That's good. Just... But that slide you get of the laser striking Earth.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And now, if anyone complains you didn't play the game to completion, well, they're wrong.
That's actually, now 20 years later, when all the entities involved probably won't care, I am responsible for that piece of programmer art because it really wasn't worth spending any resources on the "you destroyed the Earth" scenario.
Right.
And as I recall, we scanned in the picture of Boston from the cover of a Boston area road atlas. back when there were road atlases.
Yeah, you might have to explain to our younger viewers what a road atlas is.
And we drew the giant laser. I drew the giant laser thing on it in some sort of paint program. It's
basically a printout of Google Maps. That's what a road atlas is.
It's really unforgivable, basically.
Well, yeah, I mean, we didn't want to spend any resources on it. And the other thing is, like, you know, it was a little bit, I feel like, of the Chris Crawford Guns and Butter thing of you don't want to celebrate the player's destruction of humanity, right? You don't want to...
Yes. Oh, yeah.
You don't want to give them an opportunity to, like...
We talked about what to do in that case, and we did want to downplay it.
Right.
But yeah, the sort of shameful way in which we produced the art was, I think, a good
many
story.
Things in this game were shamefully produced, so you are in good. Bruford Endicott. That feels like a John Mayer name.
It really does.
head. Don't need it. It's not special. Vaporize it. And I think this is Doug Church's head, right?
Looks like.
Looks like the same. Let's see.
The one I. Yeah, you might not be there yet.
Yeah, I'm not there yet. Nothing yet.
From back when it had hair.
Yeah, on the.
Doug is at a place you may have heard of these days called Valve Software. I think he's still there. Not sure what he's working on. He was doing some VR stuff with Abrash, I think, wasn't he?
Last I heard.
Yeah, I mean, Abrash has left, of course, but I think he's still on that. I'm not sure, though.
And there's Art Min depicted. All of the real-life faces do not match the real-life. Voices. That was pretty easy. Oh. Oh, I don't need a spark beam.
There's Art Min in the face of that last log, by the way.
Yes. I mentioned it already.
Oh, I missed it.
And these are the landmines that I would have liked to have had for the death trap. I picked them up before. Another ML41 and another spark beam. If you want to be super meticulous, you pick those up and make sure they're not loaded, and you can unload the ammo. That was a bigger deal in System Shock 2, I feel like. Having some weird physics glitchiness. Oh, is this me? Yes, this is my voice acting debut. I don't know if you can hear it.
Awesome.
But you can recreate it, since it's you.
This is crazy! I'm locked out of my own office. Oh yeah, so there's a story about this, is like, you know, they shortened all the like, the text does not actually match the speech. If you play with both, you'll notice that the actual text version of the email is, like, longer. And I think you wrote this dialogue, Tim, because you did this thing about the, she's changed the locks on our front door, my poor key don't fit no more. That's like a country song, right, or something?
Okay. That could either be me or it's probably me. But it probably has to do with the fact that John Mayera also played that an awful lot around the office. That's Hank Williams, Move It On Over.
Oh, okay. So, the story behind, yeah, so there's not really any story about that, but there's this quote from this song that's totally butchered in the, when they rewrote it for text. So I don't say that quote. I say, like, she changed the locks on the doors, ordered them showdown. And, you know, I remember you complaining about how that music quote had been butchered.
Showdown ruins everything.
Yeah, pretty much. Trying to figure out where to go here. Looks like I want to turn this way. And that's the elevator, right? That's the elevator that goes back to level 1. I don't think I've been around this way much. As evidenced by the live mutants. And we do respawn guys eventually, but... Look! More for my grenade collection. All right. I seem to recall these are zero-G mutants, and they're just gonna get pistol to death. Thank you. Please die. Alright, thank you. All pain, no gain is what corpses are about. So yeah, we had this whole thing in System Shock 2 where weapons would break down, right? And you really wanted to, you know, you really wanted to keep your weapons in repair, and then you would end up finding broken weapons and harvesting the ammo out of them. And then there was like this fictional disconnect where there was this one mutant who would have in his possession, he would attack you with a shotgun. Here, I'm going to use a battery because I'm bristling with them. He would attack you with a shotgun. I'm getting into Shock 2, but when you would kill him, he wouldn't have the shotgun. It's like, dude, WTF, where's his shotgun, right? And so we ended up putting in like a, you know, almost broken, jammed shotgun with one bullet in all of those mutants for verisimilitude. And then the problem became, what?
Go, so, yeah, where's his shotgun? Screw you. Here's his shotgun.
Here's yeah. his shotgun.
So then, then the problem became, because it had one bullet, you would take it out of its... you take it out of the inventory, and then you'd take the one bullet, and then you'd like drop the stupid broken shotgun on the floor. And so, in an early version of the game, like you'd go back to level one, and it would be like just the wasteland of shotguns, just like littering the, because the mutants would respawn, right? And it would just be shotgun wasteland. And so, we actually had to like write code to, when you arrived on the level in the elevator, to like scour the world for nearly broken, jammed shotguns and assume that you didn't want them and destroy them so that it wasn't weird.
How
that
is
you
that
weren't...
the easiest fix for this whole situation?
yeah. So we really cared about the fiction, I guess, is the that's like, yeah, like, so that's our version of the infield fly rule. It's like, you know.
Right, well, the virus fed on crappy shotguns.
Crappy shotguns, yeah.
Or, like, crappy shotguns were some kind of waste product in the virus's life cycle.
well, clearly you are the virus in that case, because clearly crappy shotguns were your waste product. And this is a teleporter. It's going to take me... somewhere else, which I've already been, I think.
Wow, a lot of chat on the proper name for shotgun ammunition.
Wait, we had teleporters.
What did I say shotgun ammunition was?
You said bullet.
Oh, sorry. They were not slugs. They were almost certainly shells. yes. Pardon my firearm French. Alright, so I think I missed a part here. I want to go back through the teleporter, I think. I think I'm regretting this teleportation decision.
I will probably have to take off soon, which is sad because I was going to rant about how so much of this game was inspired by Expedition to the Barrier Peaks.
Oh, right.
Module S3. But I was saving that for the Groves.
Yeah.
I mean, you're saving that for when? The Groves?
The,
oh, yeah, sure.
Groves.
Sure, well...
I mean, the mutant animals.
Like, yeah.
I mean, the Cortex Reaver is just an intellect devourer.
Right.
I just looked for synonyms.
All right, well, I'm glad you actually gave us that rant on your way out.
No better way to sign off.
Yeah, I guess the whole sort of crashed or ruined space station aesthetic was kind of seared into my brain by that module.
Sure. Yeah. This crate is really annoying. You bump into it, you have to push it out of the way, or you just have to vaporize it.
I wonder if anyone ever found the froggy mode.
But the crate has physics, so you can bump it out of the way. That's the important part.
Right. Expedition to the Barrier Peaks. Totally forgotten about that. Like, that was like the module written by Monty Hall himself, right? I mean,
if you could possibly survive.
All right, here's the shield wear. I think I can get this and move on. Well, okay. Whether you can move on depends a lot on your DM, right? Hence.
Yes, yes.
All right.
Right, but yes, the entire rest of your D&D campaign would be contaminated by those...
right, those by the powered battle armor that you got. Yeah. Expedition to the fucking Barrier Peaks. Oh.
Oh.
Please die.
That's a lot of radiation poisoning.
Oh yeah, get some radiation. What's down here? Repulsor.
I don't know. When was the last time you saved?
Loot. Oh, more repulsor. So somewhere around here is like the cyborg conversion deactivation, which I should probably invest in. Oh, here it is. Oh, thank God. Oh. Let's see where this goes. Station. Is there a way out of the power station? We just climb out? Are we just stuck?
Chatlog is going crazy with their need for you to save your game.
Well, I hope I'm not stuck here.
We all hope.
A chat log. Oh. Ah, switch. But that's gonna be the way out. Hey, look. Alright, so this is bonus power station and bonus. Alright, so I have gotten my shield. I'm saving my game. I can power up my shield. What the heck? And.
All right, I'm going to have to bail.
All right.
This was hugely fun, though.
Yeah, I mean, it's possible that, you know, if we get to a certain point, maybe we'll just pick it up again, but...
I would totally attend a round two of this, if that's how it goes.
Right.
If anyone's interested, that is.
Honestly, now I just want to see the rest of the game again.
I know.
All right, I will talk to you guys later.
Yep.
And thanks again. Thanks to everyone who showed up on chat. Good luck.
Yeah, I'm going to need it. All right, so I think I really want to head up to level 3 and get me some... see if there's a radiation suit. Does anyone remember whether there's a radiation suit on level 3 that I can get? I feel like there is. I think it goes here, doesn't it? No. Gotta go the other elevator. Where's the other elevator? And we have this awesome, super derpy scrolling API. Oh, a scrolling UI. Because actually, you know, dragging the map around would be too fun. Okay, the elevator's here. And I just need to get there. So maybe I can kind of head around this way. Save. Maybe that was a hint that I should save. Whoa. Right. Right in here's the